The easiest way to describe a retirement home is it's a neighborhood. It's a neighborhood that's not unlike the neighborhood where the senior who's made a choice to live there lived before.
There's a lot of things I can't do anymore, and the sooner you accept that and make a decision for yourself, this is ideal.
A lot of the reasons that they're coming to retirement living is to seek out nursing services or support services.
You'll have the very, very independent where virtually the only thing you offer is housekeeping and maybe the provision of some activities where people take care of everything else for themselves, all the way down to just short of and long-term care.
Retirement home living offers seniors an affordable option. And because of the range of services that it does provide to seniors, the retirement home sector really does relieve the stress on the funded sector because people are able to live healthy lives
with the support and care that is customized for them as individuals.
And in fact, end up avoiding that step to either long-term care or to hospital.
People like us, who are already in sort of a twilight zone, you know?
Well, you're a little bit more than me, though.
Well, this is the place where they are looking after.
It puts peace of mind.
The home is able to interact with other healthcare professionals and supportive services, whether they are provided internally by the home staff or externally through agencies.
Care coordination with hospitals, with our care coordinators in the community, all of those things need to work together very well to make sure that the resident is always at the center of all the choices that they make.
Also is the development over the last few years of memory care support. These are units or in some cases entire retirement homes dedicated to supporting people who are experiencing difficulty with dementia.
We know we're providing the best care because you get to hear it from the residents and you get to see it.
One of the greatest myths that our sector has striven to overcome is the idea that retirement homes are institutions similar to long-term care homes. In a retirement home, you get to choose your room, you get to choose to bring the things that are important to you from your home, your family is able to come and go as they please, you're able to continue making choices every day about everything that you enjoy.
I wake up in the morning and I another new day. What we do today?
People are sitting in the lounges and chatting with each other. And if they feel like playing a game, they go for cards. There is a half-hour exercise downstairs that's age-appropriate, of course. But it really helps.
It limbers us up.
I get a chance to come home every night and say, wow, I had another incredible day. You get to hear their life stories. You get to learn from them. You get to be part of their life. We can celebrate a lot of special events that really cater to the needs, but really the wants and the desires of our residents so that they really love where they live. They love the new friends that they're making. They're participating in things that they wouldn't have maybe even participated in. And their families also have this great sense of relief.
Retirement homes are regulated under 21 different pieces of legislation. With all of this legislation comes regulations and training requirements for staff to ensure that residents continue to live in an environment that is enriching but is also safe and secure.
In 2010, the government decided to pass the Retirement Home Act, then formed an agency that is responsible for inspecting and regulating the operators that are licensed.
We're very proud of how the sector has addressed their new environment of regulation.
We know that our regulator works very hard to make sure that resident safeguards are first and foremost. That being said, they are also very cognizant of the fact that they have a willing partner at the table who says, all right, that's a best practice. Maybe we should accommodate that.
Believe it or not, I'm 87, and I thought they always call me the kid.
I'm 94.
And I'm 85. It's just everything is here to make my life easier.
There are more and more people who are going to be requiring supportive services as our population ages. And today, the seniors that live with us and the seniors that are going to live with us 15 years from now are going to be very different. I think good operators are constantly looking at how do we evolve? Do we integrate technology into our service delivery? Do we look at something as simple as wireless networks to connect us to our resident and the resident to their family?
I email all the family. Keep up on what's going on, who's doing what to who.
At the end of the day, people make a choice to live in a retirement home because there's an unmet need that needs to somehow be accommodated, and lifestyle around that needs to make sense.
It is a sector that is growing every year exponentially and really serving a need to be a cost-effective and vibrant choice for seniors, where they can actually get a new lease on life.